experience. It was nice to work on something that I felt... I mean, my philosophy of the world is closer to this movie. You know, I mean, I don't believe that men and women are destined to be apart. I don't believe, you know, that we're all doomed. And I'm an optimist. You know, and so it was nice to work on something that was just joyful, you know, and hopeful.
Did it help you to go into post-production? You were in post-production on Revolutionary Road.
Yeah.
And you started this. I'm always fascinated when directors do that, like Coppola writes a movie at night and he's shooting in the daytime when he's trying to save Zoetrope. How did you find that? Was this just a relief for you to start working on Away We Go?
I've done it before in the theatre, gone from one play to another, and I've always found that it's actually good for me because you work on, you know, if you have the energy, sometimes you just don't and it's just exhausting, but... I managed to sort of dredge it up on this one, and when you can do that, you become much more instinctive. You know, you don't obsess about things, you don't worry about things unnecessarily, and your choices become very clear. But also, you know, when you're in the groove making a movie, to make another one straight away, you sort of remain in the groove. You know, you just say, I'm going to change the way I'm doing it, but I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. You're just much quicker about the whole thing, and it becomes more fun. And you know, when you're like me and you work in two different worlds, the theatre and film, coming back to the film every time, you sort of almost have to restart your whole, you know, it's been a year, year and a half, 2 years sometimes, you've sort of forgotten how you do it on some level, and you sort of, it takes a while to get back in the saddle, whereas with this one, it was easy.
And I love that, I don't want to hog this up, but I just, since you mentioned the theatre, I love that aspect about your directing. And I'm wondering if you look, for instance, the dining room scene with...
Yeah.
I mean, that's out of the theater, and I sit there and I go, oh, man, thank God, this is great, he's playing in the one, and I'm going to see the whole scene. Yeah, and I'm wondering if you consciously look for moments like that where you can do it, like the opening scene, for instance, is very theatrical, you know?
I mean, it depends. You know, I can think of some people who would not treat those scenes in the way that I treat them. I mean, for example... I know that David and Vendler were shocked when they first saw the movie and delighted that the first scene, you know, was one shot, basically, and that you could see what was going on because they'd imagined it just seeing her head, you know, just this, and hearing his voice off camera and then and then only coming up into shot at the end. And they couldn't believe it. Like, they were like, are you allowed to do that? Isn't that pornographic? It was like, you know, under the covers, you know. There's a certain amount left to the imagination. But you know, it's... It's just how I like seeing the spaces in which people are living. I like holding shots for a while. I like seeing people's body language, so I don't use close-ups incessantly. You know, I feel comfortable with it because that's where I'm used to. You know, that's where I come from. But also, you know, I like telling. You know, there are more than one way to tell a story. You know, there's more than one way to tell a story. You, for example, tell a story. You know, about a relationship dependent on how close they're sitting to each other, you know, across a dining table, you know. I remember in American Beauty holding that shot for a long time with Kevin Spacey and Annette Bening and Thora Birch at the dining table and creating a table that pushed them just a little too far apart so that it felt unnatural, the relationship at the table. Well, that's a theatre thing, you know, and holding that shot because of the slight discomfort I felt watching them.
You called this, you think this is a good date movie, but it's not a conventional date movie.
No, I was being facetious.
Well, exactly.
And compared to Revolutionary Road, it's a good date movie.
So what drew you to this particular material?
Well, I felt like, it made me laugh, you know, and I thought that the parenting comedy in it appealed to me as a parent. I found that very, very funny, and I found that something that I hadn't seen. I'd seen a lot of baby comedies, you know what I mean, about what it feels like to be pregnant and the sort of crazy comedy that goes on when you're about to have a child, which, by the way, I also loved, but this was different. This was about being a parent, and the kids in the movie were never quite behaving in the way that you thought they were supposed to, which, of course, is what happens with kids. And so there was that element, but I also felt... I fell in love with Bert and Verona as a couple, and I'd never seen a couple treated as a unit in a romantic comedy in a way. It was like, you know, the traditions of romantic comedy are they or aren't they going to get together? Oh, you know, at the end of the second act, there's a run through the rain, there's some crisis, they're separated, now they're back together again, happy ending. Right? That's basically just most, I would say 90% of romantic comedy. And here's this story about, instead of a story in which the couple are turned in on each other and having a crisis, they turn outwards to face the world. They are a unit, it's a given, they're in love. That's established very early on, and you're given access to their private world. And it's the way they see the world and what they learn from the world and how they will take that and survive. And I felt that was very original, and I loved them as a couple, and I thought the film was full of joy, and it was very hopeful, you know, and it was just how I felt at the time. And you know, sometimes that's enough, you know. You don't think, I wonder how strategically this would be if I did this or did that. I'm just going to do it, you know, and I never regret it.